And it took a lot of guts, too.
Wasn't much fun for you two, either. Didn't know there was pain like that. For a while, I really wanted to die, just so long as it'd stop.
And you'd only been on that stuff a couple of months. Imagine what it was doing to your body.
When you're on it, you don't think about that. You just want to feel good and get through the day.
Yeah, well, look, Kay, the worst is yet to come. I mean, most kids go straight back on it.
Mum, I'm never going to go back on it, not now that I know.
Well, that's easy to say. But there are going to be plenty of people around trying to change your mind on that.
I won't even be around the scene. I'm going to go home to Alan. He'll help. I know I didn't listen to him before, but it's been a pretty rough lesson up here.
Wish I could be there too.
You can trust me, Mum. I won't let you down. Not after what you've done.
It's going to take a lot of willpower to keep that promise.
Mum kept hers. She said she'd help me somehow, and she did. If she can do it, I can do it.
I have given it a lot of thought, Mrs. Reynolds. I'm just not cut out for this job.
I don't agree. I know you've had the usual teething problems, and women can't help testing new officers, especially young ones. But Meg seems to think you're doing very well, and I value her opinion.
Oh, she's been very kind to me. But I'm sorry. I've made up my mind.
Are you sure there isn't something more behind this, something more specific? Heather, I want you to give it at least 2 more weeks. If you still feel the same way after that, then I'll arrange for you to leave immediately. But I've got a feeling you could see things quite differently by then.
I doubt that. I'll just be wasting your time and the department's money.
That's for me to decide. And if you have got a problem you feel you can't discuss at the moment, then I want you to know you can come and talk to me any time you want to.
All right, then. I'll give it one more go. Thank you, Mrs. Reynolds.
Not at all, Heather. I'd hate to lose you.
What does it say exactly?
An escaped prisoner bashed and robbed the owner of a milk bar. And then it goes on to say how you escaped from Wentworth.
And some bright reporter has decided I'm the one doing the bashing and the robbing.
Mum, I'm worried. It says here that the police have been told to treat you as dangerous and to shoot if necessary.
Oh, don't worry, love. It's just their way of luring the bird back into the cage.
I still have to go back.
So do I.
All right. And I'll come and see you as often as they'll let me.
I'd like that. Feel up to making me a coffee?
Sure. I'll join you.
Mrs. Reynolds, please. No, it's personal. Mrs. Reynolds? Myra Desmond.
Myra?
Yes. Look, I just wanted you to know that it's not me doing those things that are in the paper.
I believe you. You do realise that you're making it more difficult for yourself every day you stay out. Where are you?
I can't tell you that. But Mrs. Reynolds, I give you my word. I'm going to give myself up. I just need a few more hours, that's all.
How is Kay?
She's okay. Now.
I'm glad. Look, Myra, you're taking a terrible risk. I'll let the police know that you're coming back, but that won't stop them looking for you. And if they find you first...
Myra, are you crazy?
Tomorrow, I promise.
Who are you talking to?
Myra was...
Well, one thing's clear, though. Bernard did have the films at the time you attacked him.
Oh, my God. Anyone could have them now. Guess it won't be long before we find out who. Good money in porn scandals.
I wouldn't lose heart yet. I've got Freddie following up a couple of leads. And they both point to Roland.
Oh, that little bastard. I might have guessed. You get him on the phone and you tell him he'd better be here tomorrow.
Now, wait a minute. You're not going to gain anything by blowing your stack at that little weasel. Just hang on.
Just tell him to be here.
Right. You sure that's the right knob, Judy?
It's not doing nothing now. It's going faster.
I wish you'd hurry up because my bloody eyes are going skewbald.
Look, I'm doing the best I can. Now what's it doing?
Saying, oh,
stupid bloody thing, I give up.
Let me have a go. You've been pussyfooting around so long.
Watch out for that jiggy knob. Oh, you stupid bloody mole. Now what are we going to do?
I don't know what you're going to do, but I've got more constrictive things to do than sit around listening to you lot complain because you can't mend a bloody telly.
Constrictive?
She's incredible.
I'm surprised someone hasn't killed her by now, you know?
Bloody pain in the bum.
Oh. Come on, kid, let's see how you lose at blackjack.
I'm going to rip the sleeves off this and put them with that patch skirt I've got, and with the gear you've got, it should be a fabulous fashion for
her. Yeah, look, just do me a favour, will you?
Together. Looks as though her visit wasn't too good. What the hell are you doing?
Oh, I'm just making something out of this. I used to make some fabulous stuff out of the gear I had at home.
Yeah, well, some of this gear could get you put on a charge, you know?
Oh, no, I'm not worried about that. By the time I'm through with it, they won't even recognize it.
Oh, thank God. That's wonderful news. You know, I've had this little niggling worry that Myra might change her mind about coming back.
I know. I did too. She's a smart lady, though. At least now she's coming back, the police might calm down a bit too. But what about you? You sure you don't want to get to know them, miss? That was a pretty grueling experience you went through yesterday.
No, no, no. That's one of the reasons I want to work. Takes my mind off it.
Anything on Tracy yet?
No, the police are watching the airports. I think she might have left the country.
Oh, well, she could certainly afford you with your savings in her pocket. Very little chance you'll ever see that again, I suppose, even if they do catch her.
Oh, no, that's one worry I don't have. Building society have admitted fault and are going to replace it.
That's good news. In fact, I think I'd better leave. That's my second lot in one afternoon.